Now, as we continue our series of films celebrating 50 years of the Beatles, what we shouldn't forget are the movies. Fans queued up at the cinemas to see these on the first night they were out. Hard Day's Night, Magical Mystery Tour, which, by the way, is being shown on BBC Two on Saturday.
Well, look out for that. And also the zany movie Help. Several scenes in the 1965 film were shot on Salisbury Plain, as Alex Dyke's been finding out.
Love me do.
Stonehenge on Salisbury Plain is famous to Beatle fans the world over because it was here they shot two songs for the movie Help.
Please help me.
I've come with two people who remember working on that film. Betty Glazo was the film's hairdresser, and Pete Brown was a local photographer who was hired to film pieces for American television news.
Guys, something special. The Beatles back on Salisbury Plain. On a tablet computer. Look at that.
Amazing.
We said our goodbye the night before. Love was in your eyes the night before. Now today I find...
Ringo had very fine hair, very fine hair. He was the worst one to keep, you know. And George had very thick, wiry hair. Paul was... nice hair, you know, pretty nice hair, and John was all right, you know, the same, but they all had different textures, but you all had to try and keep it more or less the same, and because you used to wash it sort of every other day, maybe, or when you had a scene sequence that you had to match, so like you did a scene in the beginning of the film, then you've got to maybe have to go back to pickups, and you had to get the same continuity for a certain scene, you see, that was always a thing.
And did you keep in touch with the boys?
John I cut several times after, but then, of course, they grew it for the Rishi thing, you know, went into meditation, all that sort of thing, so they grew it really long then.
And suddenly they don't need Betty anymore.
No, no.
Here I stand, head in hand.
As we were based at Lark Hill, that's just about a mile away from where the actual film was there, and we got the call to go up there and get some footage to go over on the Early Bird satellite. It was some of the first footage to go over.
So you shoot the movie for your... the footage for, as part of your job, but you take this, your own camera.
Yeah, I take some pictures for myself.
When I was younger, so much younger than today, I never needed anybody's help in any way.
If you go anywhere and you see something that might not have the chance to take it again, take a picture. Don't think about it, take it. It might be useful later, so...
So out of two rolls of film, how many pictures did you get at the end of it?
Well, I got five good pictures.
And I do appreciate you being round.
Is there anything you could do for me?
Don't laugh, Betty, don't laugh.
Well, you look a bit beetly anyway. Not a fady beetle, but, you know.
Beetle hairdresser says I'm beetly. See you later, Pete. No, I'll be fine from here. No, thank you very much. Wow, so here I am at the Antrobus Hotel in Amesbury. This is where the Fab Four stayed, apparently all in this room, when they were filming the movie Help. I'm going to love this. I hope you've enjoyed our Beatle Magical Mystery Tour of the South.
Next stop, it's the Portsmouth Guildhall, and also a great story from 60s crooner Craig Douglas. He once borrowed some money from John Lennon and never got the chance to pay him back.
That's going to be a Beatle bebop bonanza.